Over the last few months, thousands of people across Canada have been organizing for a just recovery that puts people above profits. When COVID-19 hit communities across Canada, people came together to organize mutual aid efforts and demand no one was left behind in our government's response. People fought to ensure everyone had the support they needed to pay bills and meet their basic needs, calling for critical support for workers like decent pay and sick leave. Since the global health pandemic, the world's richest countries have forked up billions of dollars to bail out fossil fuels, with Canada giving $16 billion to line the pockets of fossil fuel companies since the start of the pandemic. That's why tens of thousands of people have been keeping the pressure on our leaders to put people before profit and reject multi-billion dollar bailouts to big oil in the midst of COVID-19. At the end of May, over 400 organizations, unions, and grassroots groups representing millions of people and workers launched the 6 Principles for Just Recovery with a commitment to not go back to business as usual of climate inaction and rising inequality after the pandemic. Together, communities built a mass people-powered movement to fight for a just recovery that ensures no one is left behind. From there, over 40 communities across Canada held digital teach-ins to plant the seeds to win a just recovery that centers people and workers. And their efforts are already showing. Hundreds of people flooded the government consultation portal in June, asking for input on a post-pandemic recovery plan. So many people participated that the government's online portal temporarily crashed. And in June, after months of tireless organizing, thousands of people delivered over 105,000 petition signatures to federal party leaders, members of parliament, and cabinet ministers, demanding a just recovery leave no worker and no person behind in Canada's green recovery plans. We need our elected officials to invest in communities right now. That means defunding dirty fossil fuel companies and investing in a just recovery that puts people first. Visit 350.org/jr-teachins to learn more about the movement for a just recovery in Canada.